My dear viewers, welcome back. In this video, we are going to study the continuation part of lesson of grade 4, that is food health. The part 1, I have put the link in the description box. You can refer from there. Half of the lesson is finished in part 1. In this video, we will continue the next part, okay? So, see, we were studying about the Deepa and carrot story, right? It was Deepa's birthday. Deepa was sleeping, eating carrot halwa full of her stomach. And in the dream, carrot came. And the conversation between the Deepa and carrot is going on. Here, Deepa is asking, animals and birds also need food like us, right? Don't they? Carrot is telling, yes, they also need food like us. Here, let us write the food of the animals given in the table. Here, some of the names of the animals are there. We have to write the which food do the animal eat. Tiger, which food the tiger eat? Tiger eats flesh. Next, crane eat fish. Deer eat grass. Elephant also eat grass. Kite is a big eagle. It eats other animals. Butterfly, nectar. Mosquito sucks blood. Cow eat grass. Dog eat bones, flesh, milk. You can write. Rat eat grains. Okay. Next, Deepa is asking, how do these animals eat food? Carrot is saying, see how animals eat food with the help of their beak, teeth and proboscis. What is the meaning of proboscis, children? Proboscis is a tube-like organ which is present on insects. Okay, see here, look at the pictures and fill in the blanks here. Look at these pictures. What can you see in these pictures, children? You can see tiger is holding the animal deer with the help of its teeth. Here, kite, this is only children, kite, eagle, it is holding the rat with the help of its claws. Here, crane is holding the fish with the help of its beak. And here, butterfly is sucking the nectar, the juice of the flower, that is nectar, with the help of proboscis. And the elephant is eating the grass with the help of trunk. Here you can see the different animals is having the different food with the help of their different organs. See here, fill in the blanks are there. Tiger tear the fish with the help of its sharp teeth. Kite has dash legs to hold its food, clawed legs. Butterfly has proboscis to suck nectar of the flower. The crane has a beak to hold its food, fish. Elephant eats grass with the help of its trunk. Okay, now here we have to write how the beak, leg and teeth help the animals to eat their food. Number one, you can write the above animals like tiger, kite, butterfly, crane and elephant. And also you can write the other animals. Here I will write the other animals. First I will write lion. Lion, what does the lion eat food of the lion? Flesh. Which is the helping organ of the lion? Sharp teeth. How it help? It help to tear the flesh. Next, second one, I will write rabbit. What does the rabbit eat? Rabbit eat nuts and vegetables. Which helping organ helps to eat that? Front teeth. How it helps to grind the food. Third, shall I write parrot? Okay, I will write parrot. What does it eat? It eats fruits and vegetables with the help of its beak. Helping organ is beak. How does it help? It help to hold the food. Okay, next, fourth one, shall I write honeybee? Okay, I will write honeybee. What is the food of the honeybee? Nectar. What is the helping organ? Proboscis. Like a butterfly, the honeybee is also having the tube-like organ in the front of its mouth to suck the nectar of the flower. Okay, so proboscis. Next, how it help it suck the nectar? Last one, I will write cow. Food of the cow, grass. Helping organ, teeth. How does it help to chew the food? Okay. So here you can write whichever animal you want, you can write here, okay? So next, Deepa is asking, oh, it is wonderful the way animals eat food. Wait, I feel hungry. Now Deepa is feeling hungry. Deepa is telling to carrot, I will go back to kitchen and I will eat the carrot halwa. Now Deepa enters the kitchen and she sees that the carrot halwa is being eaten by the cockroaches. She screams. Carrot asks, why are you screaming, Deepa? What happened? So Deepa says, see there, carrot are carrot halwa is eaten by cockroaches. Please drive them away. I have to eat the halwa. So the carrot says, no, Deepa, you should not eat that halwa. Once the animal touch the food items, it becomes contaminated. It becomes unhealthy. So we should not eat such food. Deepa says, what will happen if we eat the contaminated food? Carrot is telling, see here, read this news. Children fall ill by eating contaminated food. Contaminated food means if any of the animal or insect touch the food, it will become contaminated. So children fall ill by eating the food exposed in a fair. In a fair means in the shops, the children ate the food which is open and they fall sick. Okay, it is confirmed that the contaminated food is the cause for the illness of the children. The children who ate the food which was contaminated by flies and cockroaches are suffering from vomiting and dysentery. Dysentery means loose motion. They are admitted to the hospital. All the children who ate the contaminated food are admitted to the hospital. Now, four of them whose condition is very serious are shifted to the next hospital, city hospital, for the further treatment. So Deepa is telling, poor children. Carrot is telling, come, I will take you to the nearby fair. Carrot is telling Deepa, come, I will take you to the nearby shop. Look at the shops where eatables are kept uncovered. Here in the shops, you can see all the things which can be eat. They are uncovered. They are not kept covered. So Deepa is telling, those house flies are sitting on the rubbish. And again, they will come and sit on the sweets also. So Carrot is telling, yes, if we eat such food, we will get diseases like cholera. So we should always cover the food with plates to avoid insects sitting on them. Okay, the vessels in which we store water for cooking and drinking should also have to be covered. So we should take care to avoid pollution of water, and we have to wash our hands before eating food. Okay, Deepa said, yes, okay, I understood. So Carrot is saying, we should not eat stale food. We should not eat the food which is open. We should wash the vegetables and raw fruits before eating, because on the fruits and vegetables, the flies and the cockroaches may sit, other insects may sit. So we have to wash the fruits and vegetables before eating, and fruit should be cut into pieces just before eating. We should not eat the full fruit with our hand. The fruit should be cut with the pieces before we eat. Okay, vegetables should not be overcooked. If we overcook the vegetables, the nutrients, the proteins which are present in the vegetables will be vanished. So we should not overcook the vegetables, and our cooking destroy the nutrients present in them. Food, if boiled well, will be soft and it digest easily. The germs present in the food will be killed by boiling. So we have to eat hot food. Don't eat oily, fried and too much spicy food. Okay, so Deepa is telling, do you know I am following all these tips? Carrot is telling, then throw the halwa, throw out the halwa which is eaten by cockroaches. So Deepa threw the halwa, and Deepa's mother woke up Deepa, who was sobbing in her dream. Deepa was seeing the dream, right? Yes. So Deepa woke up suddenly and asked her mother why she had not covered the halwa with a lid. Mother laughed and said, Deepa, that it is her dream. Okay, how do you preserve food at home? Children, explain, how do you preserve your food at home? Of course, we also preserve our food at home by covering it. If anything is open, we have to cover it, and we should not eat the open food. Okay, here some of the fill in the blanks are there, children. We will answer it. The nutrients present in food are proteins, carbohydrates, lipids, salt and vitamins. Okay, vitamins and mineral salt. The nutrients present in grains is proteins. We should drink a minimum of 1 liter of water every day, 4 to 5 glasses of water every day. 4 to 5 liters of water every day. Next, night blindness is caused due to the deficiency of vitamin A. Orange is rich in vitamin C. Now, here, Write the reasons for the following statement. We should not eat contaminated food. Why we should not eat contaminated food? Because we will fall ill. We should eat balanced diet because it provides the required amount of nutrients to our body. We should cover the prepared food items properly because to avoid the insects to sit on them. We should not eat food and cut fruits kept open and sold on the roadside because it is contaminated food. Okay. Now match the vitamins and their uses. Vitamin A we have to match for it preserves eyesight and skin. Vitamin B protects heart and digestive system. Vitamin C protects teeth and gums. Vitamin D protects bones and teeth. Okay. So next here some of the facts are there. Do you know children, the sun rays help to produce vitamin D in our body. And goitre is caused due to the deficiency of iodine. Which food is full of iodine? Salt. Salt is full of iodine. If sufficient salt is not provided to our body, we could cause goitre. Okay. Major food grains that we use are rice, wheat, jowar and ragi. The food will be spoiled or become stale when germs enter it. When we eat such food, it causes diseases to the abdomen. Abdomen means stomach and the intestine. Sometimes the diseases will be severe and may cause death. So we should not eat spoiled food. Okay. Food is preserved at home by drying, salting, fuming, cooling and boiling. In the market, the food items are purified and preserved by different methods and then they are sold. For example, cool drinks, bread, fruit juice and jams. These are the food items which they preserve in the market and they will sell. Okay. So this is all about your lesson number 8. Food and health. As I have told you, there are two parts. The part number 1 description also I have put in the description box. You can refer from there. And if you want the other lessons also, it is there in the description box. You can refer there. And if you want the continuous lessons of the next chapter, you can subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.